I'd like to invite everybody, please take a seat so that we can begin the rosary. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the reward of eternal life, grant that while we beseech you that while meditating on these mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain, obtain what they promise, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. For faith, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. For hope, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. For love, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The first glorious mystery, the resurrection of our Lord. The angel spoke, "Do not be frightened. I know you are looking for Jesus the crucified, but he is not here. He has been raised, exactly as promised. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven." Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those most need of thy mercy. The second glorious mystery, the ascension into heaven. He then led them out near Bethany, and with hands upraised, blessed them. As he blessed, he lifted up, left them, and was taken up into heaven. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those most need of thy mercy. The third glorious mystery of the descent of the Holy Spirit, tongues as of fire appeared, which parted and came to rest on each of them. All were filled with the Holy Spirit. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those most need of thy mercy. The fourth glorious mystery, the Assumption of Mary. May you be blessed, my daughter, by God Most High, beyond all women on earth, and may the Lord God be blessed, the Creator of heaven and earth. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those most need of thy mercy. The fifth glorious mystery, the coronation of Mary. A great sign appeared in the sky, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet and on her head a crown of 12 stars. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those most in need of thy mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To you do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To you do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn, then, most gracious Advocate, your eyes of mercy toward us, and after this, our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of your womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand. In the waters of baptism, Gil died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory.
In the shadows of the Lord, who abides in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the flower will never capture you, and phantom will bring you no fear. Under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And hold you in the of his hand.
Let us pray. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Gil, whom you have called to journey to you. And since he hoped and believed in you, grant that he may be led to our true homeland to delight in its everlasting joy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingly proclaim the word, be persistent, whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage through all patience and teachings. For the time will come when people will not tolerate sound doctrine, but following their own desires and insatiable curiosity will accumulate and will stop listening to the truth and will be diverted to myths. But you be self-possessed in all circumstances. Put up with hardship, perform the work of the evangelist, fulfill your ministry. For I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Blessed are you, the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Alleluia.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When he saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
I lost my cheat sheet. I have everybody's name written on it. I'm so sorry. As the travelers know, I can hardly remember anybody's name. But I certainly want to begin by saying we offer the whole family, his children, great-grandchildren, great-grandchildren, our deepest sympathies and condolences as we're gathered here today to celebrate life, ultimately. That's what we're coming to do. Even in the sadness, we've come to celebrate life. And this gospel that we heard just proclaimed is from the very beginning of the Gospel of Matthew. We are about to tell the story of his birth. Matthew has a wonderful story about Jesus' birth, and we only hear about him until he's about 12, and then he kind of disappears until his great day of going out to the River Jordan to be baptized by John and spending his 40 days and 40 nights in the desert, selecting his apostles, and then here we are at a mountain. Might remind us, Moses was the great giver of the law, which he brought down from the mountain to form God's holy people to follow those designs and those instructions so that the world would see God's presence by the way that they lived. Now Jesus is on this mountain teaching, fulfilling what has been long prophesied that a Messiah would come into the world. He teaches what we call the Beatitudes, blessings. A lot of times it's easy to think, oh, these are going to happen after we've lived this life. Well, yes, that's true partially, but they're also blessings that we receive while here on earth as well. And that is what we've come to rejoice in as we hear at the end of the gospel, to rejoice in the countless blessings that Gil experienced in this life while he was here. In the language of our liturgy shortly, we'll hear that life has changed for him. It's not ended. If it's ended, then there'd be no purpose for us to really be here because we would be like those hoping in that first reading from Wisdom that the vast majority of people did not have any notion of an afterlife. And that's what really Christmas is all about. Sad as it may be, and as much as we love the Christmas season and all that comes along with it, with the little baby Jesus and everything else, the only purpose for him to have been born into this world, to have taken on human flesh, was to ultimately, after teaching, as he does in the Word of God today, teaching us how to be in relationship with God, to continue to be his holy people in this world by the way that we love one another, the way that we take care of one another, the way that we're a husband and a father and a grandfather and a great-grandfather, as Gil was, is that Jesus ultimately is born to die. To die for our salvation. And that's what we have come to rejoice in, because while Gil had his own challenges in this world, he apparently had many health things, but apparently it didn't stop him. I guess he still got to play golf and go fishing. No, golf and pool and fishing. So he got to enjoy the world in this way. But now his life has come to a full circle, if you will, here on earth. He's been born to eternal life on a day that will always be very memorable in the family, in a very particular way. But we celebrate, even in the sadness of death, we celebrate life, because if Jesus would not have come down from heaven, we wouldn't have salvation. We wouldn't have that which we long for, eternal life. So his life is now complete here on earth. And as this Paschal candle represents the light of Christ, Jesus, born into the world as the light of Christ to dispel all darkness, he's now with, completely, welcomed into the halls of heaven. There are many places, as Jesus said, I've prepared many places for you. Thomas tried to question that. We don't know where you're going. And Jesus says, yes, you do. I am the way, the truth, and the life. And so we come to celebrate and thank God for the way that Gil lived his life, believing in this Savior, believing in this newborn infant, believing that, yes, one day he will receive the rewards of life here on earth. He will live eternally with God. Please stand. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. In baptism, Gil received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Our brother Gil was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, my prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, my prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, my prayer.
Those who trust in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, my prayer.
The family and friends of Gil seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness of doubt that comes from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, my prayer.
We are assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Gil. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, my prayer.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people, whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated.
Lost, but
dangerous toils and snares I have already come, till grace hath brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Gil, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Amen.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy,
holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Paul the Apostle, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Gil, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth, he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow in the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, so that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should move, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. There's just something about that name. Master, Savior, Jesus. Like the fragrance after the rain. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Let all heaven and earth proclaim. Kings and kingdoms will all pass away, but there's something about that name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. There's just something about that name. Master, Savior, Jesus, like the fragrance after the rain. Jesus, 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 let all heaven and earth proclaim. Kings and kingdoms will all pass away, but there's something about that name. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I'm worn. Through the storm, through the night, precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, precious Lord, lead me home.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Gil may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen. And please be seated.
I just want to say, when Dina called me and asked me would I read the eulogy, it's an honor to read for your dad, an honor. We have gathered here today to celebrate the life of Gil Kohn. Gil was born in Hinsdale, Illinois, a suburb of Chicago, on January 15, 1941, to the proud parents of Raymond and Dina Kohn. He was the oldest of three brothers. His brother Carl was 5 years younger, and Ray was 17 years younger than Gil. He enjoyed hunting, fishing, swimming, and even ice skating during his childhood. He was blessed to have his grandparents for many years. He really loved spending time at the family's lake house and on the boat at Lake Delavan in Wisconsin. He attended St. Gertrude Catholic Church in Franklin Park, Illinois, and was very involved in sports and youth groups. Through his high school years, he was very athletic, playing basketball, football, and baseball. He was a car enthusiast, attending car shows, working on cars, and even racing them. He was very artistic and outshowed many in art class. In 1959, he graduated from Linden High School and then attended Chicago School of Art in the fall. Gil was living the best life in Chicago, and then in 1961, his father, an international harvester executive, had life-changing news. He was being transferred to Memphis. He moved with his family to their new home in Scenic Hills. It appeared to be like a Leave It to Beaver neighborhood. Gil's plans was to live in Memphis for a year and then move back to Chicago with his best friend. Well, all that changed. He met the love of his life, Sarah Nell, at a Catholic club. He was in the Navy, and at that time, she would talk about her handsome sailor to her friends. They dated a year. Gil and Sarah Nell had their parents come out to Ray and Dina's house. They thought a lot of each other's families. In June of 1963, they were married at St. Thomas Catholic Church by Father Murray. Gil was always a hard worker and a proud worker. He worked in construction in HVAC for a brief time. He even tried painting for a while, but his father-in-law, Benny Edwards, said, "I don't think this is your field." He then started his career in printing, engraving, and graphic arts. He found his niche. He started working, stripping film, plate molds, and moved to vice president through his career. He had an eye for perfection. Only the best quality would do. And he had a no-play attitude. His expertise was a drawing card to land accounts with large companies like Dillard's, Cook's, and Love Shoes, and Kodak. He was always on business trips. On a personal note, I would like to add, I had the pleasure of working with Gil on numerous projects. He was always polite and professional. However, the best thing was, I always benefit from his expertise that he was so willing to share. I am grateful for all the tricks of the trade he taught me. I appreciate all the time he had my back in meetings with clients and all the positive remarks he made about me to my peers. I admired him both personally and professionally. Family was always top priority with Gil. Even his first house was brought in Parkway Village so that he could be close to Sarah Nell's family. Gil bonded with his brother-in-laws immediately, Ed Mack, Barney Costello, Harry Edwards, and Tommy Edwards. Gil always told everyone, "Nobody cooks like my sister-in-laws." He loved all his nieces and nephews too. Gil seized every opportunity to travel, spend weekends and holidays together with his family and in-laws. On December 2nd, 1968, they finally had their handsome baby boy, Ben, named after Sarah Nell's father, Benny Edwards. 6 years later, they were blessed with their beautiful daughter, Dina Marie, who was named after Gil's mother. Fast Jack informed Gil that Ben should have been named after his father per Irish traveler tradition. He laughed and told him, "Looks like Sarah Nell pulled that one over on you." In 1976, they had a house custom built in Bartlett, less than a mile from his brother Carl. There are no words to express how close Gil and Carl's relationship was throughout their lives. Gil was devastated when his brother passed away. I bet they already played some good pool in heaven. Gil and his baby brother Ray had become so close over the last few years. Gil was always a good provider. He spoiled Sarah Nell crazy. He had the best work ethic and was an exceptional example of what a man should be. He was the best father. He made sure Ben and Dina went to the best schools, belonged to a country club, new cars, and even had a swimming pool. He took his family everywhere and did everything he could to make their lives comfortable. Dina married Chris McDonald in 1992 and had a beautiful wedding, and her father spared no expense. Chris was a godsend for Gil, especially at the end. Dina is just like her father, and Chris says, "She's a perfectionist. I wonder who she took that after." The next year, Ben married Bridget Marie. Gil was so happy Ben had settled down and said, "Thank God for Bridget Marie." Ben always had long talks with his father and took him fishing to eat breakfast and on trips with him. Gil was very proud of Ben being an honest, self-made, successful business owner. Over the next few years, Gil was blessed with grandchildren, Michael, John, Eddie, and Sarah Danielle. He was in every game, play, sacrament, and each and every event for all of them. He would say his grandchildren was his greatest accomplishment. They all had one particular thing that they shared with their papa. He was so proud of his grandsons and their wives. Michael, he took pride in you becoming a civil engineer, and he so admired Victoria's love of animals. He was impressed with John's determination and business smarts, and Madison, he commended your pursuit for a career in criminal justice and treasured your dedication as a mother. Gil's great-grandchildren made him smile and laugh. Raleigh made Gil have the gleam in his eye again. He could not get over Paxton growing so fast. Sarah Danielle had Papa's heart from birth. He could talk to her for hours about anything. He was thrilled when Sarah Danielle and P. Jude was married this year. He loved every minute of their wedding day. After Sarah Danielle passed away in September 2019, Gil was not the same, almost lost after being married for 56 years. The sudden death of his grandson, Eddie, on December 10th, 2016, was unbearable. But Gil was strong for his family. Then 4 years to that date, December 10th, 2020, Gil was reunited with Eddie, Sarah Nell, and all his loved ones. I know that we'll be watching Notre Dame from the best seats in heaven. On behalf of the family, they would like to thank every one of you for your prayers, phone calls, and being here with them today. The family wants to especially thank Father Kenny and the choir for making this such a beautiful service.
Please stand. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Gil, and now we come to the last farewell. There's sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Gil again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
Jesus, lead you into paradise. And may the martyrs come to welcome you, to bring you home into the holy city, so you may dwell in New Jerusalem. May holy angels be there at your welcoming, with all the saints who go before you there, that you may know the peace and joy of paradise, that you may enter into everlasting paradise.
Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our brother Gil, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, you will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon him in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.